the winners from the tennis ball throw. Number 168, 168, 151, 151, 96, 96, 70, 70, 104, 63, 154, 36, and number 225. Please go up to the mezzanine where you box your tennis balls. If you are a winner. .168, 151, 96, 70, 104, 63, 154, 36, and 225. Please go to the mezzanine. Thank you. welcome everybody to Tiger Field Hats for tonight's volleyball match between our visiting team, the Jeech Trojans, and your Broken Arrow Tigers. This volleyball match is the best 3 out of 5 contest. And now for the rosters from both teams, starting with the Lady Trojans from Jeech.
Thank you. Welcome to Tiger Fieldhouse and Tiger Volleyball, where the number four ranked Tigers of Broken Arrow hosting the state's number one ranked team, Jinx Trojans. These two teams have met before, early in the year, obviously. Back in August, the Tigers won 2-0 in Broken Arrow's tournament. Jinx rolled back to win it in September, just a little less than a month ago, by a 3-1 count in the Bishop Kelly tournament. So the rubber match is here tonight in Tiger Fieldhouse. I know it may seem like midnight madness right here, but a little bit later than we're supposed to start, by about an hour and 15 minutes. Freshman game went long. Tigers got a win there. And in a best two out of three, ends up Jinx nabs that one, just barely in a close one. It was 15-13 in that final set. So good was denied. This could be a preview of what you may see at the state tournament in just a couple of weeks. Of course, the Tigers coached by Ian Bullen. Jinx led by Tana Smith. And I am Steve Callen, bringing you a call tonight along with the rest of the crew here from AeroVision. Setting up to be a good one. Jinx is going to serve first. So Tigers have a chance to get something set right off the bat. Kendall Carolina up to serve for the Tigers. For the Trojans. Hartz goes down. Hartz is going to get it back. McGrath going for the block of the Tigers and into the net. Tigers get the first point of this one. Barnes to serve. That one's deep, hard to handle back there. Oh, just skips off the tape. Unlucky break there for the Tigers. Skipped over the hands of Benzel. Borchers back to serve, just a sophomore, as was Carolina, who served earlier. Now the pass just a little long and right, perfectly set up for senior Ellie Smith. So an easy one there for the Trojans. This one should be a good one for the Tigers to get. Quick set and back right at. Unfortunately there, Avery Jones had it come right back at her. Ainsley Hopkins. Hopkins filling in tonight. As the Tigers are without Emma Stubbs, that one goes in the net. So 3-2 the lead. Emma Stubbs having some back issues. She could have played. But holding her out, because this one really means nothing, because other than bragging rights, the regionals have already been set. Broken Arrow will be hosting. We'll go through more of that later tonight. Nice block up there. A couple of gals for the Tigers. Reagan Sharp was in the middle of it. Jones looking to get a second straight service point. Oh. Impressive set and kill there for Borgers. So as you can tell from this one, it's going to be a back and forth match all night long. No reason not to expect this one to go five. So settle in. The night's going to be a long one, I anticipate. Far side, oh, what a kill right there. Grace Marshall coming over from that left side, put that one away. Grace Marshall, the epitome of consistency, coming in from that left side. Matty Torelli to serve for the Tigers. Good crowd tonight here for BA, and Jinx has brought some fellows as well. Oh, a little dink falls in good, just over the outstretched block of Boswell and Sharp. And then that's an unforced error right there and comes back to the Tigers. Marshall will be back to serve for BA. Oh, and that one's going to go up to somebody in the bleachers over here on the Tiger side. Pretty good set and kill there for Trojans on that one. Carolina Wood, a junior, back to serve. Gets it back deep. Handled, however. It comes over to the left side. They're going to go down and get that one. It's Torelli. Ooh, that one was just out. Tigers catch a break there. Sharp now to serve. We're knotted at half a dozen. That one's out. A long set there. And Jinx couldn't convert. Tigers take only their second lead of the night. See if Sharp can run off a few more points here. Get something going for the Tigers. Tigers in play ready for that little dunk and dink. Not to be confused with the dink and dunk. Again, they try to go down the line and it's wide. So a couple of misses on some good sets for Jinx. And Tigers right there ready to defend. Oh, that serve is long. So flips back over. Not before the Tigers run off three in a row. Brent Roberts on the service line back for Jinx. Oh, and unable to handle the serve there. Came in across it. Cross pretty stiff. Maddie Blackburn couldn't get her fingers on it. Actually got her fingers on it, but couldn't do anything with it. Back at Maddie. Comes a set. It's going to be a free ball for the Tigers. Teams with the block. In a scramble now, going to the far side. Blackburn goes down and gets it. Or excuse me, correct that. Yeah, that was Blackburn who got it. There it is, point for the Tigers. Haley Alexander to serve. See if she can get it rolling. Oh, and into the net, unfortunate. Oh, you don't want to give up those freebies like that. Unfortunate. That's going to set on the left side. Oh, Jeeves was in the spot. Going to get a free ball here for the Tigers, see if they can get a good set out of this.
Ooh.
Able to get that one over and get something going. See if we can get a block. Tips it over. Keep it in play one more time. Harnes puts that one down, but still Jinks is right there. And they tip it in. Oh, way to go down and get that. Ball still stays alive. There it is. That one more time. Without a doubt, Benzo put that down with authority. Got it through the block and got the point. Net on the Tigers as Borgers went into it. Broken arrow. Taking a two-point lead. Maybe get this up to three in the way it's going. Back and forth. That may do it as we rush into 25. Oh, nice dig. Tigers going to keep that in play. Good free ball there for Broken Arrow to keep it going. Kill back up again. Oh, almost. After a nice try there by Harnes. Kill came down a little steep for Borgers. Just need to keep the ball away from her, obviously. Tiger's going to have a chance on this serve receive. Nice dig there by Benzo. Borgers again. Into the net. Now let's see what Jones can do. So serve deep in the corner. Barnes with a good one. On the dig. Benzo tries to put that one away, but Jinks keeps it up. Nice block in there. Tigers, they get it. Sharp and Benzo joined together for the block, and Tigers go up 13-10. Jones gets the service call. Patiently waiting. Harassment coming over there. Fun harassment coming from the Jinx student section. That was close. That was close, but called out. Tigers let that one go. A little risky. Good solid serve there. Tigers again keep it up. A little tip on the block coming on the left side. Tips over and gets down. Nicely done. Nicely timed. And Marshall did the right thing and just tipping that over and got a timeout. So Tigers open up a 15-10 lead, forcing Jinx to take a timeout. Tana Smith wanted them to get things reset. Jones comes in with a service rating of over two, so that's extremely good. And keeping things alive for the Tigers. Again, as we mentioned, playing without Emma Stubbs. Let's talk about just a little bit about what the Tigers may be missing with Stubbs. She's got 183 kills on the year. That ranks up there for her teammates. Not the top of the list, but certainly is missed over there is Emma Stubbs. But she will be back for regionals that are coming in. And as I said, on our next break, we may take a little bit of time to talk about regionals and what's coming up next Tuesday here at Tiger Fieldhouse as the Tigers host regionals. 15-10. BA with the lead. Let's see if Jones can kind of stymie that timeout. Tigers are ready for the little dink. They got it. Benzo comes in and tries to drop it over, can't get the point. That one's put down into an empty spot by Ellie Smith, so the run stops, 15 to 11. We are some way about halfway through the first set as this game started very late. Oh, back into the face of Haley Alexander. So that one couldn't have felt good. With the Trojans on serve right now. Wilkener leads it. Finzo finds an open spot in the corner. Tigers back up by four. Matty Torelli in. Into the net. Oh. That's frustrating when that happens to the coach and to the server. Audrey Wright set to serve for Jinx. Middle set and could have put away to Sharp. Right there in the middle. That's the first middle set of the night for the Tigers. And Sharp did what she needed to do with it. Marshall to serve. Cross blocked him down. Sharp and Boswell in there teaming up. Well, that could have been one. Maybe Jinx, let's go. Blocked again, but the Tigers are there to handle it. Far side blocked again by the Trojans. One more time, a little quick little set across the court. Jinx is ready for it, but it's going to be a free ball to get things going for the Tigers. Here comes a set. Wide and back, and Trojans with a dig. Tigers try to keep it in play. We're going to need a double hit, maybe. Interesting call there against Sharp. So Jinx gets the serve back, trailing 18 to 14. Caroline Wood. Junior libero to serve. Attacking from that left side again. Oh! What a dig there, but came right back. She goes down and gets another one. Jinx able to keep this one in play. Going to be sent across and free. Here comes the set. Right in the center. Oh, and the block. Sharp couldn't get that one over. Talking a little bit, giving a little tip there to Reagan, or maybe what she should maybe hold back before coming to the net so quickly. Yes, sir. Down but not out. Deadly in was what that was for Harns. Oh, out again. Tigers catch a break. Little block just goes out. Tigers have built a 5-point lead, 20 to 15. I think at this point you may anticipate a Jinx timeout if Tigers can get this point. Oh, down to get it. It was Torelli, but he had to dig it but couldn't handle it. Yeah, ready for Roberts' serve. And it was out. Nicely done there by Blackburn. Knew she couldn't handle it. Knew it had to be long. Alexander coming in to serve. Oh, a nice dig. Alexander was on that one. Blocked by the Tigers. Going to be a free one coming over. Let's get it going. Blackburn with the set. Pass, I'm in. Here comes the set. Cross the way on the left. Jinx is able to keep it going. One more time on the left-hand side. Girls are getting after this one, and oh, the block, but it just goes out long. Tigers can't maintain the point. 21-17. Back to Carolina to serve, and she started it all off. Actually, the serve started to be A side, but. Tell you what, Alexander is just right there waiting for it, and it's good. Oh, and Jinx doesn't dispute it. Right there in front of Bryn Roberts, and it hits the line. Harnes back to serve, and timeout Trojans, as expected. Tigers got a little run there. They've kind of gone on a stretch. Well, they've outscored Jinx 4-2, and that's been enough to help them build a five-point lead at 22-17. Tigers coming off a three straight losses. They lost to Bixby last night, 3-1, and that's Bullen's first time to ever lose to Bixby as head coach of the Tigers. Bixby will be hosting one of those regionals coming up next week, and they'll come in at number 8. So congratulations to the Spartans over there, but the Tigers have also lost to Bishop Kelly, and we had the Norman North, the 3-2, the tough loss here at home just last week. So been tough going, but before that stretch, the Tigers had won 7 of 8. And so they were on a roll with wins over Union and Owosso in that stretch. Here they go, back at it. 22-17. Harnes ready to serve. Oh, can almost call that a service ace. No return there. Capable for the Trojans. Attacks the same way with that serve. Blocked and out on the Tigers' side. So service will go back over to the Trojans. Far side Marshall, partially blocked. Free ball coming back, nope. Tigers should be able to get this one back. Jinx River will set something up. They'll have another chance to set something up. Oh, and not able to do something, trying to get tricky over there was Kirkendall, and didn't work. So now Tigers are at point, 24-18. And several points to play with. Jones can get this taken care of in one swing of the arm. He's there to keep that one alive. Pinzo had a chance. Still in play. Oh, having to track it down. Jones gets it, keeps it alive for the Tigers. Sharp's going to go across with it. It's back Back in play for Jinx, going for the kill and finding an open spot is Ellie Smith. Jinx regaining the serve. That's going to be long. Tigers are going to win it on a giveaway, 25-19 BA. So we're going to be back with the second set after these words from your Aerovision sponsors.
While you are teaching someone special the nuances of keeping the wheel steady, we can provide you means for you to maintain financial equilibrium. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
Right now, get $200 from TTCU Federal Credit Union when you open a new checking account with direct deposit. What would you buy with $200?
Cars, race cars,
my own apartment,
100 coloring books, and a puppy.
Or maybe some groceries and a tank of gas. $200 for whatever works for you from TTCU, because life is better in balance.
There is nothing like teaching about the rewards in life, like catching.
Recently, you've had to put your life on hold, and we're with you in this. At Ascension St. John, we're now open for appointments, and we are fully prepared for your safety and our care. As we open our doors again, our doctors, nurses, and care teams will continue to wear personal protective equipment. We've taken even more steps to clean and stringently disinfect all areas. We will maintain distancing in our waiting rooms and will continue to limit visitors. And we will still screen all staff to protect their health and yours. Our emergency rooms are here 24/7. Please do not delay care. We're still delivering babies and performing surgeries. And we're open for your appointments, from specialists in surgical care to routine care and health screenings. Ask us about virtual visits. Ascension St. John continues to care for you, as we have been for almost a century. Thank you for trusting us.
Welcome back to Tiger Fieldhouse, and as you all know, unless you're buried under a rock, it is homecoming week for the Tigers. And Allison Benzo, who's playing a spectacular game thus far tonight as the Tigers win set one, is the homecoming queen representative for volleyball. And homecoming queen and king, the court will be celebrated tomorrow night just before kickoff of your Tigers football game against Westmore Jaguars. 6:30 is the set time for the homecoming coronation. So come on out tomorrow night for homecoming. Cheer on Broken Arrow Tiger football. Homecoming parade was today. Got out in very festive time for the Tiger faithful, all the way up from elementary school through, of course, the high school years. And, of course, a lot of alumni, including our great graduates that will be recognized tomorrow night at halftime of the ball game. Tigers will be ready to serve it here, hoping for the same results in set number two that they enjoyed in set number one. Alexander to serve and into the net, unfortunately. So, an automatic giveaway of a point. The Tigers can get this point back, and no, they're not going to be able to. So let's just say the Tigers came out a little unfocused after that first set win. So they need to grab it back, a serve in the net, and then the inability to handle the serve. Jones gets that one, gets it and play a little better. Sent back, another chance. Here comes Harm for a second chance at it. Block up in the inside by Ainsley. And Jinx knocks it down. Set all around, and not the kind of start to the set Coach Bullen was anticipating. Already in a 4-0 hole. And most of it is of the Tigers' own doing. That one goes out, so they catch a break and get the service back. And let's see if they can Marshall can do something here for the Tigers. Get some of these points back. And that serve goes out. So two serves for the Tigers, two service errors. One into the net and one just wide. You want to hit an authoritative serve and do what you're best at, but you want to get it in, obviously. And on this serve, Tigers have to send over a free ball. Nice block, though, in there by the Lady Tigers. And Jinx returns the favor on Harm's attempted kill. Or excuse me, Benzo's attempted kill. Back row. Oh, nicely done for the. Gonna go to Benzo again. Got that one down through the block and onto the court. On the Trojan side, Allison Benzo puts it away. 5-2. Jones to serve, only down three. Nab him back. Jones is set ready for that one. Benzo, nope. Jones was ready for it. There's the block! Benzo and Sharp, put it back. Tigers kept that with some live, with some intended play. Block, here we go again, another chance. That was out. So the Tigers' blockers have been just enough of a distraction and up high enough to force some of those kills wide and long. Nice serve. Jones very deep. Ball stays in play. And blocked up front. Oh, but stayed on this side of the net. Thought Sharp and Benzo had another one. But it comes down on the Tiger side. Unfortunate there. The Tigers did battle back, scoring three in a row and cut it to a one-point game. It's now two. And Tigers there take care of it. Benzo this side goes across. Oh, and that ball would have been out. Tigers get the block in there by Sharp at the front. 6-5. Tigers making a couple of changes as Torelli comes in to serve. Boswell also checks in. Oh, got a whistle. Now we're ready for play. Torelli was anxious. They serve zone, going over into the Jinx bench, but they're going to rally and get it back in. Tigers are getting a chance to set something up easy here. Boswell was blocked. Jones able to kind of get that one up. Sharp's going to send it over. A little free ball for the Trojans. Oh, nicely played Torelli. She comes in again. Tries to earn that one. She doesn't want to quit serving. Torelli's going to chase that one down in the way. Jones is going to send it over, and it crawls across the net. Another chance for the Tigers. Torelli comes in and gets a set. Good hustle there. She's been all over the court on this point. Oh, another double block. Can the Tigers do it again? Jones goes and gets it. Torelli pushes it over. Jinx is able to put it away. Nice point there. Unfortunately, it goes the Trojan way. 7-5. Quick set. Center. Guiding it over with Sharp. Trojans get it. Now Tiger point. Tigers just need to get over that hump here. Maybe with Marshall serving, they can do it. Try to get over that sluggish start. Nice serve. An ace for Marshall. Grace Marshall. Good serve. Oh, and that one comes off the block. Nothing to do about it. Trojans take the lead again after the Tigers have tied it up. Outside the court. That one put back by Harnes. See if Tigers can get a set off this one. Off the court again. Tigers get a chance on that block. Kind of regained momentum a little bit there. Harnes blocked. Going down against Blackburn. Blocked. Boswell. Sharp was there beside her. I think Boswell got most of it. Tigers get the point and tie it up. Sharp's going to be serving. Miscommunication there, I think, what the set was going to be. And Tigers had a chance to get a point down, just couldn't take advantage of it. So service back to Jinx side. Passes and sets. That stretch right there. Coach Bloom going to have some words. Come on, girls, let's get with it. Something like that. End of the net. All right, Tigers got a chance. Back to within one. Coming in to serve will be Alexander. There we go. Gets it started. Far side. Oh, Jinx may have given up another point. Little dink. Yeah, and they get that one's Alexander. Coming over to the left side. Oh, it's just long. Was it tipped? Was it tipped? No, it wasn't. Jinx Point. Oh, tough break there. Thought Trojans may have got a fingertip on that one. So it seems like we're just exchanging points since it was 8-7. Although Jinx didn't win two in a row there at one point to make it 10-8. But then it went 10-9. Now it's back to 11-9. Tigers want to get to 11-10 right here. Oh, and it was tipped. And the point goes the Tigers. Denzo gets that one. Arns is going to serve. Serve deep to the opposite corner. They're running and gets that one in play. Far side and getting it down. A nice set and kill right there by Marshall. So that little series tied it up. Tigers now looking to take their first lead of the set. Get down, ball. Nope, serve too hard. And right when Tigers getting ready to make a run, we see something like that, an unforced error. Trying to get the serve down. It's like some coaching over there as far as let's get your hand in the right spot. Just had it up a little bit, angled too high, and forced that one to go long. Benzo tipped. Ball down. Benzo gets another one. Jones coming in to serve. Jones' last serve got 2 points for the Tigers. Closed the gap from 5-2 to 5-4. And a service ace. And the Tigers have taken a 13-12 lead. Let's open it to a 2-point lead. Oh, not going to be able to do it. Aaron Johnson put that one away. It's 13 all. Skims the net and falls down. Right there in front of Harns. Almost couldn't ask for a more perfect serve. Just gets over the nets for Woods, for Caroline Wood. Tries to go the same place. Harns is there. Sets his side. Benzo puts it down through the block. Torelli coming back in to checks in to serve. Benzo and Alexander come to the bench in that rotation change. Dinked up. Torelli goes and gets it. Jones with a set. And hey, right there, Marshall puts it away. Tigers taking a 1-point lead again. Stretch it out to two now. Torelli can get the serve in and keep the chances up for the Tigers to, and she hits it long. Twice in a row now, the Tigers had a chance to build on a lead, and both times the server sent the ball over the back line. That one's long, so the favor is returned. Marshall to serve. And Tigers are going to go up as that one hits into the Jinx fan section. Tigers up two now. Marshall with a service ace. See if she can reach back and pull out a few more of those. That's going to be good. Jinx will have a chance to play it. Oh, and just out of the reach of Torelli. Blackburn checking in. Marshall coming out for the Tigers. Carolina to serve. Jinx wasn't quite ready for that one right there. Oh, Tigers got to keep. Oh, no, under the net. Unfortunate there for the Tigers. Had a chance, ran down the net. And Marshall Doeford just couldn't keep it in play. Turns the pass, here comes the set. Marshall's going to put it away. No, but Jinx is there to take care of it. Blocked by the Tigers, but bounces on their own side. Unfortunate. Tigers were there to take care of it, just unlucky. Jinx builds a lead now, scoring three straight, two on this service point. Out, that was close. Thought for a minute there we had some miscommunication, but we had perfect communication as the Tigers let it go by, and here's Sharp at the line to serve. Middle set. Oh, and no one could get over there. A little confusion. Torelli and Sharp. Sharp coming to the bench. Jones checks in. Borgers to serve. Good 8 feet behind the line. Comes up. Jones goes down and gets it. Into the net. Tigers were late reacting to that attempt at a dig. 20-18, timeout, broken arrow. Tigers come in with a record of 22-9, Jinx 27-4. And as I mentioned earlier, the two have split their previous matches, both those in tournaments, one back in August here at Broken Arrow, Broken Arrow Varsity Tournament. Tigers won that one 2-0. Then on September 10th at the Bishop Kelly Tournament of Champions, Jinx wins that one 3-1. Tigers are up 1-0 so far in this late start. And by the time we get out of here, it could be midnight madness. Jinx jumped out to a quick lead in this one. 4-1, didn't have it far enough, and then had a 5-1. Tigers have been fighting back, clawing back ever since, and didn't take their first lead until 15-14. Chance for Jinx here on a free one. Yep, and they took advantage. Kirkendall put that one away. ...21-18 right now. Tigers have some battling back to do. Does it start right here? Jinx keeps it alive. Torelli from the center, putting it away. Ainsley Hopkins. Benzos Alexander. Got it across. Oh, and they missed the set. The set was a little high. Ella Franks came in to put it away, but, or excuse me, That was Ellis Smith coming in to put it away, and it didn't work. Couldn't get the ball. They feed her this one. Oh, I'm going down to get it as Alexander. Ball tipped. Blackburn keeps it in play. Kirkendall's attempt was blocked. Which way are they going to go with it? Going to keep feeding Harnes over there. Runs down the tape. Coming in the net were the Tigers, and they have, the Trojans, and the Tigers have tied it up at 21. Alexander keeping this service game going. Oh, and just dropped in. Oh, I thought I was going to run down the tape and finish on Jinx's side, but it decided, nope, I'm going to crawl over and fall down on Broken Arrow's side. Unfortunate break there for the Tigers. That's one of those the girls were everywhere and ready to be all over that one. And that's when your kill into the tape turns out good for you if you're the one doing it. Harnes far side and gets it down. Returns with a little bit off the top of the tape. It didn't roll down it, but it skipped off of it. Harnes now to serve. And the Trojans are going to take a timeout. So again, if you're just joining us, Tigers won the first set. They fell down 3-1 and then kind of rallied back and tied it at 4. And then the game was give or take. But that set was give or take for a while. Tigers then go up after it's tied at 9, 11, 11 to 9, and then it goes 11-10. But then the Tigers run off 4 more and kind of start pulling it away at that point and stretch the lead out to their biggest lead. Was 20-15, and they maintained that at 21-16. Then they got up to 23-17, end up winning at 25-19. Right here, we're tied at 22 after Jinx had opened up a 4-0 lead in this one. The Broken Arrow scrapped and battled back, tied the set at 8, fell down 10-8, and then came scrapping back again, tied at 11, then took their first lead of the night at 13-12. Or in this set anyway. And then after it was tied at 13 and again at 14 and 15, Tigers go up 17-15, but Jinx goes on a run, scoring 6 of the next 7. And the Tigers get it there and they take their lead. It's 23-22. Tigers were down 21-18, but that serve right there by Harnes was an ace. And Trojans take another timeout. They're busy doing that, taking some time out. Let's look and see what we've got coming up on Tuesday. It's regionals right here. The Tigers are going to host Putnam City. We'll have 4 teams visiting us. Putnam City, Stillwater, and Mustang. And, yes, we will be carrying the stream, and we will carry it throughout the night. So folks in Putnam City, Mustang, and Stillwater will get a chance to see their teams play, but of course, whenever Broken Arrow plays Putnam City in the first game at 4:30, I'll be here with you on the call for that one. The Mustang and Stillwater game, Muskogee and Stillwater. I may have said Mustang, misspoke there. It's Muskogee and Stillwater will play at 6. And then the winners of the two sets, or two matches, will play at 7:30. And we anticipate the Tigers being there, and we'll have the call on that one. Unfortunate serve in the net, and now this one's tied at 23. So a timeout, and just enough to break up the focus and the roll that Harnes was on the service. Jones can't handle the serve. It got past her hands. Let it get past her body. Couldn't do it. It's 24-23, set point. And now Coach Bullen's going to call a timeout. As you may or may not know, tonight was Stand Up to Cancer Night for Broken Arrow Volleyball. They do this, of course, every October, at least one game. And tomorrow night at football, it will be a night of Stand Up to Cancer, too, Breast Cancer Awareness Month. Tigers had a little fun you may have seen if you had tuned in early with tennis balls. They were selling tennis balls to raise some money for a needy a member of the volleyball family who is as a family member with cancer issues. So they were going to donate the money served there, and there was a prize to be given away to one of the persons that could get a tennis ball in a trash can. There were about eight of them that made it into one of the four trash cans, and then a lucky tennis ball was drawn there, and a prize for that. So kudos to Tiger Volleyball of stepping out and recognizing one of their own and trying to help that family out. Oh, and that serve gets down, and so the Tigers lose it. So we'll be going to set number three with it all tied up at one after this on AeroVision.
If you and your family have been waiting for the perfect time to jump into your dream home, it's here. We make buying a new home as easy as it is exciting with quick credit approvals and great rates. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
Right now, get $200 from TTCU Federal Credit Union when you open a new checking account with direct deposit. What would you buy with $200?
Cars, race cars,
my own apartment,
100 coloring books, and a puppy.
Or maybe some groceries and a tank of gas. $200 for whatever works for you from TTCU, because life is better in balance.
Isn't it nice to know that you can spend your weekend any way you like? We have convenient e-bank products such as online banking, mobile deposits, mobile banking, and account alerts, just to name a few. E-bank, whenever, wherever, why ever. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
All right, welcome back. And if you're not here live, well, you're missing out. Nothing bunt cakes being sold over there. And on breaks, I've been taking advantage of a chocolate chip nothing bunt cake. And it has been delicious. The only thing that keeps me from eating the rest of it is that I'm responsible for talking to you guys. Pass along a little kudos and recognition to Christina Gold in the Tiger Special Olympics. A little fundraiser, silent auction, live auction night last Saturday. Raised over $8,300 for Special Olympics of that auction. And I got to help out there as doing the live auction. So it was a lot of fun that night at the Chili Cook-Off, the annual Chili Cook-Off. And thanks to all those who participated in helping raise funds for Broken Arrow's Special Olympics program. Christina Gold, the Special Olympic coach, does a great job of setting that Chili Cook-Off up, and with all the help she has from her team and her parents, do a great job out at Centennial of gathering baskets for silent auction and some of the live auction items that are there. As a guest of some city officials and state officials and some other celebrities there to help out with the auction. So in set three, Jinx is going to have the serve. Starting it off, number eight, Julian Borchers. Oh, Collins takes the first serve, comes across Harms with a kill and back at her. And the block leads to the first point of the set for the Trojans. Tigers had their chances in that last set, but couldn't come away with the win, and a block there by the Trojans. Big double team up front, and then sending it back over there was Ainsley. Harns to serve. Pop gun go off, it sounded like. Oh, Kirkendall puts that one away. Must have been a balloon, not a pop gun. It's a homecoming week, as we mentioned, in the student section. Dressed up as, I don't know, I got a pink flamingo over there, some pink balloons. Obviously, because it is Stand Up to Cancer, Breast Cancer Awareness, of course, the pink is the color. Harns puts that one through the block and ties it up from this right side. Excuse me, Benzo. Got so excited there, I saw an 8 instead of a 1. Blonde-headed ponytails. Just did a check-in number. I was checking ponytails and hair color. That one's going to go into the stands, and so the serve right there works out for the Tigers, for Jones. Avery Jones attacks the same spot again. Tigers on the block. Marshlin Sharp right there. Didn't let anything come across the center. See if Jones finds that same spot one more time. Yes, she does. A little better played by the Trojans that time. And the kill gets down by Noli Perdue. Right to serve for the Trojans. Marshall almost had one. Right in the right spot was Harns. Marshall tapped that one over. Team's going to have a chance at it. And find the back corner where no one was Marin Johnson. That play knots the score. Two extremely evenly matched teams. Pedro wants to. Benzo will try to put that one away. And they can't run it down, so there we go. Tigers back on top. Boswell. Torelli. Torelli obviously here to serve. Going to be a serve. Oh, Jinx was able to corral it, keep it in play. Tigers need to take advantage of this free ball. Far side and cranking it up over there. Couldn't get it down. Was Marshall. Ball tipped at the net by the Tigers. Trojans gets the points, and they tie it up. Caroline Wood back to serve. Into the net, back the Tigers' way. All right, see if Grace can get some stuff going. Grace Marshall on the service line. Run off a few for the Tigers. That one's back deep. Trojans attack. Marshall sends it airborne, but it's out. So after we hit 4-4, it went 5-5 and 6-6. So the teams have traded points. Neither team winning a service point the last five serves. Excuse me, the last four. Let's make it five on this one. Tigers have to track that one down. And they do. But the Trojans put it away. Took advantage of an opportunity there. Ooh, that block, but it's out. Well timed, well played. Just went the wrong way off the hands. That was tipped. That was tipped. See what they're going to do. They're going to talk about it. One of the line girls had it tipped. I had it tipped. Let's see what they say. They're discussing it. I believe it should be Tigers point and Tigers serve. There it is. Yeah, the ball, it was definitely tipped. So instead of 9-6, it's back to 8-7. Sharp will be serving. Sometimes some of the toughest things you got to do as a junior varsity player is come out and be a line judge, and that one's down cleanly for the Trojans, but it's to be a line judge. Could put you in the center of some controversy as a young junior varsity player. But they're all used to it, because that's the way it goes. Of course, until you start reaching tournament play in state. Tigers able to get an easy one that time, an easy drop down there for Boswell and Hopkins. Alexander to serve. Kirkland takes no prisoners, puts that one away easily. She had her choice of where to go with that one. Smooth set. Benzo puts that back in the face of Kendall Carolina. Gets the point. Harns now needs to get some points for the Tigers here. Needs some good service games, and that one's going to be long. So that was not what the Tigers had in mind. Certainly not what Ian Bullen had in mind, and not what I envisioned happening. She's just keeping the Tigers at bay. That one's long. Jones now to serve. Benzo with a chance, and it works out perfectly. Sends it down the tape on a parcel block. Enzo saying, hey, let's have a good night maybe before they crown me homecoming queen. What do you think? Xander was there waiting for that little dink. Enzo again with another chance. Ooh, almost in the scoreboard. And oh, well done, well played, and put away by Marshall. That one just hung up there and was waiting for her. Almost hits the scoreboard, but then it does hit Marshall's hand firmly coming through and point for the Tigers. Oh, Jones' serve is long. Shift change there for the, sound like hockey, shift change. Couple position changes, Wright is in the serve. Tigers going to get that one, Sharp. Jinx is going to get a chance in the middle. Tipped up by Sharp and then under the net. Momentum. Let's see if the Tigers can halt this little two-point momentum swing. And that one's out, and they do it with some help. So now we're tied up at 13 as the Tigers get serve. They're tied up at 13 last game. That's where the Tigers kind of went on a little run, but they are last set, but they couldn't manage to sustain it. And that one's long. So just like game before last, or match set before last, Jinx goes up 14-13. But they went up 14-13 on serve last time. And this girl was doing it. Oh, gets a point there. Ace for Carolina Wood. Go back to the same spot. Arms handles it. Oh, Wood goes in and digs that one out. Nicely done. And put away by Marion Johnson. So the Trojan is trying to stretch this one out. Tigers need to put a halt to it. Yeah, Wood's doing a great job with her service. Marshall Long. Coach Bullen's going to take a timeout for his team. Trojans go on another little run, a four-point run, if you will, to stretch this out to 14-13. Kind of recap, it was 14-13 last game, but last set, but the Tigers stretch that one out, going scoring four the next five, making it 17-15, but then the Trojans battle back, take an 18-17 lead, and then after it's tied up at 18, Trojans run off three, Tigers then run off three, and it got tight, 21-21, and tied at 22, tied at 23, but the Trojans get the last 2 points, actually the last three, because they tied it up at 23, and win that one 25-23. Of course, the Tigers win set one. We are in set three. Broken Arrow is down, 17-13. This turnaround, this timeout, change the tide. Marshall, yes it does. Tide is changed for the moment. Let's see now, Marshall put that one away. Let's see if she can put away some serves. blocked but out. Trojans get served back. Gonna have to fix the pole that indicates that the ball went out around outside or is out. Can't hit that pole sticking up. The red and white one. Ooh. Red one down big. Oh, there's one that's out. Tigers get a break. They're back to the serve. Let's see if Sharp can run off a few. When I say a few, I mean maybe 10. Go 25-18 Tigers, win this one. Oh. Borgers was going to have none of it. Alexander checking back in. Boswell checking out. Kendall Carolina serving for the visitors. Kirkendall tried to drop it over, couldn't do it. Barnes wanted to put that one down. Torelli goes and saves it. Barnes, nope, she's blocked at the net. Point Trojans. Tigers in a 5-point hole that's going to be challenged to dig out from. That one's long, but if you get help like that. Alexander serving now for the Tigers. Find some spots over there, some weaknesses. That would not be one, as Borgers puts that one away. Trojans have the ability, when they find themselves in trouble, go to number 8. And she is just a sophomore. Didn't quite time the jump. Bullen's going to call a timeout. Going to have some approach angle chats over there with Benzo. Again, tomorrow night, homecoming. Festivities, the crowning of the court. Starts at 6:30. Kickoff time for the Tigers and Jaguars of Westmore is at 7 o'clock. Key district battle, especially when you start looking at seedings for districts. Just to kind of refresh, if you don't know about football this year, it's the top 6 teams in each of the 2 districts make the playoffs. Teams 1 and 2 get a bye. The third team that finishes third in the district will host the team that finishes sixth. The team that finishes fourth will host the team that finishes fifth. District playoffs start November 11th, on Friday, November 11th. So a chance for the Tigers. That one's just out. Was it tipped? And it was, no, it wasn't. Trojans. Just 2 points away of getting set number 3. Biggest margin of victory thus far. Hit the post. So that one's out. And you can't hit the red and white post, and we just discussed that just a little bit ago. Harn's attempt just nicked it. Not Harnes, but there's one that's out. That one by Harnes went out. On the other side is Benzo. So 25-16 in set number 3. We'll be back for set number 4 here on AeroVision after this.
Recently, you've had to put your life on hold, and we're with you in this. At Ascension St. John, we're now open for appointments, and we are fully prepared for your safety and our care. As we open our doors again, our doctors, nurses, and care teams will continue to wear personal protective equipment. We've taken even more steps to clean and stringently disinfect all areas. We will maintain distancing in our waiting rooms and will continue to limit visitors. And we will still screen all staff to protect their health and yours. Our emergency rooms are here 24/7. Please do not delay care. We're still delivering babies and performing surgeries. And we're open for your appointments, from specialists in surgical care to routine care and health screenings. Ask us about virtual visits. Ascension St. John continues to care for you, as we have been, for almost a century. Thank you for trusting us.
While you are teaching someone special the nuances of keeping the wheel steady, we can provide you means for you to maintain financial equilibrium. First National Bank of Broken Arrow. First people put people first.
Right now, get $200 from TTCU Federal Credit Union when you open a new checking account with direct deposit. What would you buy with $200?
Cars, race cars,
my own apartment,
100 coloring books, and a puppy.
Or maybe some groceries and a tank of gas. $200 for whatever works for you from TTCU, because life is better in balance.
Welcome back here on AeroVision, Tiger Fieldhouse, Tiger Volleyball. Tigers trail it 2-1 after winning the first set. They drop the next two to the top-ranked team in the state, the Jinx Trojans. Now, speaking of top rankings, of course, the reigning national champion Broken Arrow Pride has recently held its Broken Arrow Invitation, BAI, but October 29th. They'll be hosting OBA, Oklahoma Bandmasters Association, competition here. And you might want to come out tomorrow night and catch them out live, because we were streaming their first two home games, but they were only showing their what they call the Oklahoma show. It's a little patriotic show. So now you'll see a little bit of what they are be performing at the St. Louis Regional, the BOA Regional, and the and in Indianapolis when they go to Bands of America National Championship, protecting, hoping to bring back another national championship. That's on November 11th when they go to Bands of America in Indianapolis. They'll be up there that weekend, November 11th and 12th, competing. Of course, last year, they set a record for highest score ever at Bands of America, and ran away with almost every conceivable award out there. And good luck again to Darren Davis and the Pride of Broken Arrow. But Kelly Pence also, who is top-notch. Darren's right-hand assistant, runs a lot of it. Tigers get a block on that one and send that one back the other way at Kirkendall, and there's another block. The Trojans able to keep it alive. Who can find the empty spot? Enzo thought it might be her, but wasn't. There, oh, nice block. Enzo and Marshall on that one. Kirkendall again. Alexander was there to send it back. Benzo. One of the best points of the night. Tigers get a block, and the point right there, Broken Arrow. So they start off with a 1-0 lead here in set four. Haley Alexander sends that one even out of bounds in basketball. Man, you grab momentum. Coach Bullen wants them to serve the ball hard and make it as challenging as you can. So when that happens, what you just saw is could happen. Tigers still a pretty good serving team, though, comparably when you start looking at stats. That one gets down. Ainsley Hopkins put that over some blocks and to find a spot. Harnes to serve. Wow, that was effective. That was like a line drive. Almost like the net wasn't even there and just hit the ball through it. Can Jones get to it? No. Oh, that was just an unfortunate break. That ball just happened to go from the Jinx side to the Broken Arrow side where no one was, as they were just trying to keep it in play. Tough break for the Tigers on that one. Play that same ball, same way, 10 times, and that's going to be the only time it's going to happen like that. Benzo wants something, no, doesn't get it. Oh, and again, an empty spot. Jinx finds the nowhere land again. Neither team has really been able to swing a big run. At the most, it's been 4 points in a row the whole night. Oh, nicely done with that anticipation by Hopkins. Goes up with two hands and puts it in a spot where no one is. Hopkins had that one measured. Ooh. Tell you what, Johnson gets going. She's dangerous. Set and blocked, but out. Trailey and Boswell back in. Trailey to serve. And that time. Borgers tried to get cute with it and just tap it over. Didn't work. Tapped it right into the net and back onto her side. 6-4 Tigers. Forceful serve there from Torelli. Ooh. Johnson put that one away. Curly is waiting for that one. Here it comes. Marshall. Marshall again. Rolls down the net and scores. There it is. Marshall from the right side at the second crack at it. Got the point. Out. on the tape, falls over. Point Tigers. Timeout, Trojans. So let's recap that. So what we're going to be doing on Tuesday night with regionals right here. 4:30. It's going to be Broken Arrow and Putnam City. Tigers, of course, the top seed in that region when you get a host. The top eight teams get a host. And the winners of each region will meet in the state tournament. But at 6 o'clock, Muskogee and Stillwater will face off. And then, assuming the Tigers win, they play the winner of Muskogee and Stillwater. Putnam City comes in with a record of 7-21. So odds are definitely in favor of the Tigers of reaching that 7:30 final. We'll have all three games for you on Aerovision. I'll be here with the call for the 4:30 game, and then if the Tigers go on and win that one, I'll have the call with whoever they play, either Muskogee or Stillwater, with a chance to go to the state tournament. And the swings are coming big from Marin Johnson over there on the left side. Had to get the, as Blackburn came in for Marshall, had to make sure they had that checked out right, so she had to do it again. Only your libero can libero can come in and, oh, that one almost came back here to me. Only the libero can go in without officially checking in. They can come in, send someone off. In. Harns almost didn't really matter where she was playing. I don't know if she could have played that serve anyway. A serve over there for Carolina. Center set, gets it down, is sharp. Block. Boswell. Coach Bullen telling Boswell, go up there and hit it hard. Hit it hard, hit it down. Well, seeing that open spot there, Purdue found an open spot and just kind of tapped it to it and ties this set up. Oh, gonna go with the towel and wipe off a little sweat area just outside the game of court, the game of play, and Lauren Harms is doing that. So the sweat is dried up, and Borgers is ready to serve. Wow, Torelli really had to chase that pass down. Tiger still able to get a point. Alexander in the serve. Tigers lead at 11-10. Oh, and that one's out. Just missing wide. Sorry, Trojans number three, Magdalena Crystal. I say Boudreaux, Benzo. Alexander's able to pick that one up. Here comes Benzo. Oh, nice play over back on the other side by Caroline Wood. And Blackburn goes to get it. Tigers keep it alive. Blocked by the Tigers. Oh, using her forearm to send that one back. Big rally point. Arms. Nope. Couldn't get the full swing on it. Blackburn gets the set. That's going to be a point for the Tigers. Benzo gets it. Nicely played rally by each club, but it turns out to go in Tigers' favor. Arms to serve. It was blocked and out, and so a point for the Trojans.
On the right, she will serve. And number six, Mary Johnson.
Aubrey Light with a little spin of the ball and a serve, and oh, I'm going down, have to find that one. It was Jones. A little free one comes over easy. That one comes back hard. Maren Johnson does not mess around. Is not messing around. Maren is not messing around. Ooh, just missed the back of the tape. Gonna call for a tip. We're gonna have to tuck this one over. Not sure about that one. I did not see a tip. Not saying it was there or wasn't. I think this one's gonna belong to Jinx. Let's see. Oh, no, Broken Arrow gets the call, so it's tied up. Tied up at 13, yes, tied up at 13. Another 13-13 score. Jones to serve. Oh, nicely dug there by Harms. Marshall keeps it going. They try to tip it over there on the Jinx side. Doesn't work. Goes out. Harms gets out of Marshall's way on the serve here. It's probably a little shorter than she liked. Arms goes down and gets it, but it went all the way across the net. Keeps that one alive. Marshall's able to play it. Set coming across. Benzo can't put that one away. Oh. Maren Johnson is able to put one away. Unlucky there. Oh, just keep feeding Johnson. Coach Bullen giving his girls some encouraging words there. So keep fighting, keep fighting. Center. Marshall couldn't get it down enough. Trojans again. Owen again goes over and claps encouragement to his girls. Tigers can't find a point here soon. Coach Bullen will probably be doing more encouraging and calling a timeout and having a little chat, get him to relax. Oh, block that stayed on this side of the net. So there goes that timeout. 17-14 right now. It's a three-point game, and the Tigers are going to have to win this one if they want a chance to continue playing. And what is the roadmap? Let's look at it down. If you go down and check the rankings, Jinx at 27-4 is ranked first. Edmund Memorial 25-5 ranked second. Then Bishop Kelly 24-5. Broken Arrow 22-9 coming at fourth. Edmund Deer Creek at 19-9. Norman North 19-10. Edmund North 19-13, and then Bixby 18-12, and they have Owosso coming to their place for regional. Owosso 18-13. And rounding out the top 10 is Edmund Santa Fe. And of course, they were playing Edmund North in the first round of regionals. Union will be going to Norman North. Moore going to Deer Creek. Stillwater, of course, coming here. Trojans ready to serve. Tigers can find a point here. Marshall, look at that one. Going to get a free ball now. We'll get something set here. And it works out. There it is. Marshall gets the point, putting that one away on a nice set by Alexander. And Tigers going to be serving. Torellian to serve. Laces would be nice right here. Oh, trying to get tricky on the front line, just tap it over and kind of like faked her. It was going to fake the set to Johnson coming in, but didn't work. I don't know if it would, even if it would have gotten over, if it would have worked. The Tigers were ready for that. They were in possession. Just wide as Johnson misses. She had plenty of room, but just got a little too fine with it. Nope, gonna be overruled. Apparently that was in. And the umpires overruled it. So, now we're gonna have a challenge. Nope. It's gonna go Jinx's way. So it's 18-16. Kirkendall puts that one away. Tigers can't let Jinx stretch this one out too far. They need this point right here, 19-16. Set can Marshall do? Oh, blocked right back at her. Boswell tried to get that one over, didn't work. Timeout, Tigers. Timeout, Tigers. Congratulations to Coach Randall King and his Lady Tiger softball team. They will be playing in this state tournament next weekend. They won regionals in the championship game. Jumped ahead 16-0, ended up winning 16-3 over Sand Springs. So congratulations to Coach King on another season, great season, another season state bound for Tiger softball. And of course, if you're not well aware, Broken Arrow cheer. State champions in the competitive co-ed division, large co-ed division. Tigers were state champions. Just last week. So things are going well in the fall for Broken Arrow Tiger Athletics. We anticipate our Tigers volleyball team to match that feat of the Tigers softball team, win regionals and then go on to state. As we will be hosting regional volleyball regional here on Tuesday. Tigers will get Emma Stubbs back for that one. Again, we mentioned playing a little shorthanded tonight with Emma Stubbs out with some back issues. And that one's long. So Marshall now to serve for the Tigers. Just wanting to run off four or five straight and put the Tigers on top. Force a set five. Okay, that one was apparently just a little wide. Some discussion there. Timeout for Jinx. It's 28-18 and Coach Tana Smith wants to chat with her girls and say, hey, don't let this thing get away. Coach Bullen's going to chat with his girls and say, hey, let's jump. We're going to jump back in this thing now. Scored two straight. Let's score about seven straight and put it away and take our chances in playing the first one to 15. Of course, win by two. Win by two here as well. But still work to be done for your Tigers. They break the huddle. They're ready to go as the clock ticks down for this Jinx Trojan timeout. Trojans are back on the court. The buzzer has sounded. We're ready for a little bit more volleyball. Out as well. So missing on this side was Johnson, and she's hit just about everything up until then, but misses wide. She's missed twice wide on this side, coming from this side. Kirkendall, Tigers handle that one. They're going to go to Johnson again. It was Jones to handle it. Torelli. Tigers go from the back. Middle set. That one's taken care of by Borchers. We haven't seen Borchers or called her name much lately. They're in the middle. Trojans send Carolina back to serve and with hopes that she'll serve in these next four out. Tigers have different ideas, though. Let's get this one going and get down, and let's see what we can put away from Harms. Wood was there to handle it. And a good set. We're going to come from the back row. And it worked! Blackburn put that one in a spot where they ain't. I think she even shocked herself a little bit with that shot. Her reaction sure did show it. Get a block. Torelli goes down and gets it. Little dink. Torelli finds that one. Right one of the pass. Harms. Can't totally put it away. Torelli thought she found an opening. Oh, and that time Kirkendall does. Quick set in the middle. Coming across to put it away was Hopkins. Nice set. Coming to her, though. Alexander goes down and gets that one. Oh, and blocked. Kirkendall didn't get the kill, but she got the block. Trojans just 2 points away from finishing this match off. Arms. Oh. Not sure if it was tipped or not, but they say it was tipped. And Smith didn't agree with it. Tigers get the point. Arms to serve. Blocked by the Tigers, keep it alive. Oh. And a little dink puts it at match point. She hit it out. Benzo hit that one out. 25-22. So the Trojans, the number one ranked Trojans, take this in four, 3-1. We will be back here on Tuesday night with regionals starting at 4:30 as your Tigers host Putnam City. So for the AeroVision crew here working, Greg Spencer, Terry Spryder, and half a dozen students. I'm Steve Cowan saying good night, and we'll see you on Tuesday.